We are going to have the one more chapter, polarization. Okay, let me go for the diffraction. So as you all know that, let me introduce the what is actually diffraction. Diffraction is simple. If someone asks you, diffraction means it's a bending of light or spreading of light because of the aperture. Okay, if there is any aperture, okay, it's a bending of light around that aperture. Okay, very good. Or you receive the 45 minutes from all. So diffraction is a phenomenon which is actually spreading of light or bending of light with any slit or aperture. It could be circular aperture, it could be a slit, double slit, etc. So diffraction, what is the condition to have the diffraction? Can anyone answer it? What is the condition? There is a condition, right? Lambda should be equal to or approximately equal to size of the slit or aperture. This condition is very important. Note down that. What is the condition to have the diffraction? The wavelength of the light. What is that? The wavelength of the light must be or approximately equal to the size of that slit or aperture. So note down that. So diffraction pattern can occur, or pattern occur, when the light from the aperture is allowed to fall on the screen. So there is a screen, beta. This is a screen, right? Here it's a source there. You keep the aperture here. Whatever the light is coming from the source, which falls on the slit first, because at this slit you have the diffraction pattern again, and you can able to see the dark and bright fringes on the screen. It's good. Then, Naveen, please take the screenshot of the all the attendance names. I already took it, but I did not cover all. So Naveen, please just make it, send it to me. Right. So, and when a narrow opaque stacking, what is a narrow means? It could be like this. You can see some examples here. When a narrow opaque obstacle, or it could be aperture, or it could be slit, whatever, be placed between what? Then we have to place source of light and screen. So walk aside source, the other side should be, screen, where you collect the image. The one side is source. Between them you have to place the aperture. Because of that you can see there is a dark, white, bright, this is the image. Due to these slits, you can obstacles. You can also see the building edge. Because of the edge also sunlight underwent diffraction. You can also see how it have the different color because of the diffraction. Why you can see all color? Why we can see all color? Can you put it in the chart box, please? Enduku manaku different colors vachayi? Can you put your answer in the chat box? White light.
Interference.
Yeah, that's good. It's a diffraction actually. Yeah, it's a diffraction and interference. You can say that. But since we don't have the many waves, we cannot tell that interference. So it's a white light definitely. White light, from white light, you have all colors definitely. When you place the white light, and when the white light incident on any aperture or any slit, it just spread all because of the various wavelength of the different colors. You can see simple answer is white light has seven colors which has different wavelengths. So that's good, very nice. Moving into the, here you can see another example. Very nice. as a result of diffraction, edges ante doors kani windows kani small holes kani, as a result of diffraction the edges of the shadow or illuminated region are not sharp, but the intensity is distributed in a certain way, depend upon the aperture, depend upon the type of aperture. It could be small hole, or it could be big hole, it could be edge, whatever. You can see here, these are the diffraction patterns. These are the few examples. You can have the moving of the lights. They don't move actually. These are not moving, but you can feel that they are moving. So these are the diffraction. You can also see when you keep a certain object into the water, around there are waves. But when you see the spreading of waves, clearly see there is a dip or there is a up. Up is a bright, dip is a dark. Ante dark white fringes manaki. We can able to see that. Wow. We can able to also see that single slit and double slit. Any aperture unte chale. When this waves, when the planar waves incident on the single slit, you can have this kind of diffraction pattern where you have collection of white dark, white dark, white dark means bright dark is makes sense. So bright one, dark one, bright one, dark one. Similarly, and when you have a double slit, you can have the interference as well as the diffraction pattern. You can, here you have a diffraction, here you have a diffraction, but when they interfere, you have the it's kind of mixed process is going on in a double slit. You can keep in the chat box. Is it okay? Any doubts in this? Yes. If you say yes, if you have any comments or no, please put in the chat box. Or if you didn't understand, just put it in the chat box. Use it. Meek language vachchu kada, you can use Telugu lo English lo rayandi, but you have to use that chat box actively. It should be like interactive class. Yes, you don't need to speak, because when you unmute the mic, maybe you may hear sound, but chat is the right tool, right? Okay. Okay. Is there any issue? Oh, it is clear. Thank you. No doubt. Very good. Naveen, very nice. Akila saying clear, sir. No doubt at all. Very nice. Yes, that's great. It's really great. The okay. Very nice. No doubt, sir. Akila. Then very nice, Gautami. Nice. Okay, sir. Okay. Then Huygens principle. What is Huygens principle? What is the Huygens principle? Huygens ante manaku first evaraithe wave nature ni discover chesaro, who discover the wave nature of light, ante wave nature untundani cheppindi, who said it first? Huygens is the scientist who proposed the wave nature of the light. Newton is the scientist who proposed the particle nature of light. Both who discovered de Broglie. Okay, very nice. So now, what according to this great scientist Huygens, what is that? According to this principle, it requires that every wave spread out after they pass through the slit. So this is a slit. When they pass through this, you can see their wave pattern around it. You have the spreading of light after they pass through the slit, then form an initial line of travel is called diffraction. This is the diffraction, of course, but every point on wave front act like a secondary source for the next wave. So from here you can think about it another wave, from here you can wave, there are waves like this. So every point on the wavefront acts like it's a source for the next wave. Akkada nunchi inkoka wave kuda raavadaniki దాని మీద ఒక్కొక్క పాయింట్ కూడా యాక్ట్ చేస్తుంది. ఇన్ జనరల్ డైఫ్రాక్షన్ అక్కర్ వెన్ ద వేవ్ పాస్ త్రూ ఎ స్మాల్ ఓపెనింగ్. ఇట్ కుడ్ బి ఎనీ ఓపెనింగ్. మీ డోర్లో చిన్న హోల్ ఉందనుకోండి, ద లైట్ కెన్ పాస్ త్రూ ఇట్ అండ్ స్ప్రెడ్ ఇన్ టు ది ఆర్ స్ప్రెడ్ ఆర్ బెండ్ ద లైట్ అండ్ యూ హ్యావ్ దస్ డైఫ్రాక్షన్ ప్యాటర్న్. ఓకే, ఇట్ కుడ్ బి ఎనీ అబ్స్టాకిల్, షార్ప్ ఎడ్జ్ అని ఉండొచ్చు, బిల్డింగ్ అయి ఉండొచ్చు, ఆర్ హోల్ ఆర్ విండో స్మాల్, బట్ ద కండిషన్ టు హ్యావ్ ద కండిషన్ టు హ్యావ్ ద డైఫ్రాక్షన్ ఈజ్ వాట్ ఈస్ ద కండిషన్ బెటర్ లాంబ్డా అప్రాక్సిమేట్లీ ఈక్వల్ టు ది సైజ్ ఆఫ్ ది అపార్చర్ ఆర్ స్లిట్. దట్స్ ఇట్. What is the lambda? Lambda is the wavelength of the light. How? It could be laser light. Laser could be different wavelength. Red laser, blue laser, green laser, violet. All lasers you can find it. Okay, that's good. Then you can also have a single slit placed between the a distance light source, a screen produces a diffraction. I mean, this is we have been talking about it. We have to keep the source. There is a single slit and there is a screen. What are the requirements to have the diffraction? You need a source, you need a screen, you need a single slit or slit. And what you need, lambda should be approximately equal to size of the slit. Then you have the diffraction pattern. That's it. But everybody, now it's clear for diffraction, I guess. Diffraction, if I ask anyone, yes sir, we know that. How many waves you need for diffraction? One is enough, sir. Two is okay, but with one also we can able to. Whereas the interference, sir, interference definitely we need two waves, sir, because they have to interfere. But what are the requirement diffraction better? The diffraction definitely, sir, the light wavelength should approximately equal to the size of the wave. Whereas in the interference, it's not like that. In interference, it depends upon the distance between two sources, coherent sources, and the distance between the screen and coherent sources. Capital D and small d, lambda d by d, right? Beta is equal to lambda d by d, lambda small d by capital D. So capital D is the distance between the screen and coherent sources. So that is the condition, is that. So capital D should be maximum and small d should be, it's a distance between the two coherent sources, that should be small. So you know that in diffraction, in interference, we need a two slits, right? And that this is their D, where and screen should be here, this is the capital D. And source should be here, and S1, this is the S2. From with this we can get the interference. Diffraction we don't need, just source, single slit, screen, but the size should be wavelength of the source of light. And we have a question, 4 marks question, differences between the diffraction and interference. You have to answer this question, collect the points. These are the important points. It will have the broad, intense central band. Central band baga intensity ga untundi, fringe pattern. The central band will have flanked by a series of narrower, less intense second. So manaku first di chala ekko intensity kanipistundi, tarvata takko intensity ga vastundi ila. Okay, first one has a more intense. The central band will also be flanked by a series of dark band. So central mottham kuda manaku dark band. That's good. Is it clear? Can few people put the chat box? Gautami, Sayed, Vashim, Patima, It is ready. Anyone can? Few people. Naveen, yes. Yes. Thank you. Okay. Very nice. Clear, sir. Saikir and Gautami, very nice. Very nice. So, you can. One more thing. The results of single shift cannot be explained by the geometrical optics. Geometrical optics, we didn't get, sir. What is the geometrical and tail layer beta? You are just keeping this setup. Okay? So, single slit cannot be explained with a set, simple setup, we cannot explain. As you know that geometrical optics would say that light ray traveling in a straight line should cast a sharp image of the slit on the screen. It is diffraction beta. Here you don't have the no diffraction. So, without diffraction you can have like this. With diffraction you can have the day. With this, by looking itself you can able to see the diffraction pattern. It depend upon the size of the slit. Here no diffraction, here diffraction is there. Very nice. This is very very important question for 4 marks. How many marks? 4 marks question. Let us very carefully, we have to keep in our brain. What do you have to do? I want to keep all these points in my brain after this class, because very very important question will be there in 4 marks. The first point. So see, what are the types of diffractions? What are the types of diffraction? There are 2 types of diffraction, but not the. Someone asked, based on this, it's a geometrical shape dependent, that's it. But other diffraction types are different. We have the X-ray diffraction, neutron diffraction, electron diffraction. There are 3 more diffractions, but these are different. These are based on the structure dependent. If it is the case of the nucleus diffraction, we use the neutron. If it is a structural detection, we use X-rays. If it is electron-related structure details, we use electron diffraction. But this is different. Other than that, based on the optics, geometrical optics, ante ekkada emem pedutamo ane place ni batti, we differentiated by 2 types. Fresnel. It's not, we don't call Fresnel. We call it Fresnel. So S is silent. Fresnel diffraction, Fraunhofer diffraction or Fraunhofer diffraction. So based on the geographic optics, we have classified into how many types? There are 2 types. Okay, very nice. Then what are the conditions in two of them? I'm gonna go for one by one. The first point, we use the cylindrical wave front in Fresnel. Cylindrical waves. Sir, how come the cylindrical waves are? I have seen planar, but I have seen spherical. But how can I see the cylindrical waves, sir? And this is a task for you to learn tomorrow. Search for way cylindrical waves. I'm going to talk tomorrow. So tomorrow you have to come up with planar waves, spherical waves, cylindrical waves, 3 types. So I'm going to talk about that tomorrow. Today we use the Fresnel cylindrical waves, whereas Fraunhofer plane waves. Like this, we use the plane waves in a Fraunhofer. Okay, whereas second point, this is the one point is over. The second point going into the source of screen at infinite. From infinite distance from the obstacle. What is this? Source of light should be placed infinite distance from the slit. Slit ikkada unte ekkado source untundi. It should be placed far from the slit. This is a slit, screen, and screen also is far. Source of light and screen should be placed either side of the placed infinite distance. No. Finite distance. Sorry, finite distance. So source of light. Okay, source of light S and screen S. Placed between the slit, place either side of the slit in a finite distance. Finite, I always confuse this, but don't confuse you guys. Finite distance ki infinite distance ke andar telusu kada. You guys know that, right? What is the meaning of infinite and finite? You could spell the pronoun. Nana. What do you know? Finite and infinite distance, right? Finite ante konta, limited. Infinite ante it should be longer distance. Okay. So Fresnel ante gurtunchukovala, cylindrical, finite. What is finite? You have to keep source of light and screen should be finite distance. And the other case, observation distance is infinite. In practice, often at a focal point of lens. So here we keep it infinite distance. So we don't know. It should be very, very far. Now we got 2 points, 2 marks. How many marks you got? 2 marks. You got it. Very nice. First point is clear. Cylindrical and planar. Second point is clear, sir. We know that in Fresnel we keep finite distance either side of the slit. Source screen ni rendu vaipula oka finite distance pettam sir, whereas in front of our low we keep it infinite distance. So we got it, sir. Very nice. 2 marks. Then moving into move in a way that directly corresponding with the shift of the object. We can move in a way that directly corresponding with any shift in the object. అంటే ఆబ్జెక్ట్ ని ఇట్స్ నాట్ ఏ ఫిక్స్డ్, యూ కెన్ మూవ్ అడ్జస్ట్ ఇట్, యూ కెన్ మూవ్ ఇట్, రైట్, యూ కెన్ మూవ్ దాట్. సో వేర్ యాజ్ అదర్ వన్ ఈస్ ఫిక్స్డ్, వీ కెన్ నాట్ మూవ్ ఇట్. వా, వి గాట్ 3 marks, రైట్, వి గాట్ 3 marks, 3 points, 3 marks. ఓ గ్రేట్. And go for the one more point. Fresnel diffraction pattern in a flat surface. We collect it in a flat surface. Whereas the other case, diffraction we can on a spherical surface. We can collect the pattern, diffraction pattern of Fraunhofer on a spherical. Wow, I got 4 points. 4 marks. బోనస్ పాయింట్ కోసం ఇక్కడికి వెళ్దాము. విల్ గో ఫర్ బోనస్ పాయింట్ చేంజ్ యాజ్ వి ప్రొపగేట్ దెమ్ ఫర్దర్ డౌన్ స్ట్రీమ్ ఆఫ్ ది సోర్స్ ఆఫ్ స్కాటరింగ్. ఇంకా మనము ఇఫ్ యూ చేంజ్ ఇఫ్ యూ ప్రొపగేట్ దెమ్ ఫర్దర్ అంటే ఇంకా మనము ఎక్కువ మూవ్ చేస్తే డౌన్ స్ట్రీమ్లో వస్తుంది. వీ కెనాట్ సీ ద విజిబుల్ కరెక్ట్ క్లియర్ ఇమేజెస్ ఉండదు, క్లియర్ ఫ్రింజెస్ వీ కెనాట్ ఏబుల్ టు సీ దట్. And here shape and intensity of Fraunhofer diffraction pattern, this is constant. Here it's a variable. Here it's constant. Wow. Great, sir. We completed everything in our brain. Are you sure? Sure. I know that you are really smart people. I know that you are going to be future scientists. The first point, let us recollect it. I'm going to test my brain. First one, what is this? Cylindrical. You can also test it. First one is cylindrical, right? Which waves we can use it? Tell me. Cylindrical. Second one, let's stop it this, and then let's share, stop sharing it, then asking it. Okay, first point, we use it cylindrical wave, right? We use a cylindrical wave in Fresnel. The second, we use it plane waves in Fraunhofer. Right? Very nice. Second point, we can keep the source and screen fine at distance in case of Fresnel. Where in Fraunhofer, we should keep it in a infinite distance. Second point is over. I'm testing myself. Then third point. Can anyone? Movable. Very nice, Amulya. So third point, it can be movable, whereas in Fraunhofer it's a fixed. Fourth one is good, Amulya. Fourth one is can be collected pattern on which surface? Flat surface. Very good. And in case of Fraunhofer, spherical surface. Very nice, Amulya. You have good brain to keep it. Very nice. So the fourth one is, it's not a constant in case of the pattern that you collect it. As you move further, you don't get that downstream. Where other case, constant. Wow. We got good points. Very nice. So moving into the, I can take few more, I think 10 more minutes, because I don't want to overload you. I'll make you fun, not overloading. That's my job, is to make a fun and learn. The way of learning is in a fun way. The way of getting information to your brain, it's like a normal interaction. Okay, 24 members actively participating, but I can see only responses for few members. I want to see all. And this is the diagrams you can see, guys. How the parallel waves, this is a Fresnel example, this is a Fraunhofer example. Parallel waves you can see, cylindrical waves you can clearly see. These are the types kind of cylindrical, but you can clearly learn more about the cylindrical. Okay, here you can see this is a screen where you can collect the P point. Screen is this one, right? And here screen is this one. From here, planar waves are coming, and you kept your slit is here. I mean, if you are thinking this is the source or this is the source, doesn't matter. You keep in the slide, or if this is the source, you keep in the slit here. So relation between the both diffraction by single slit, how you can keep it. So here it can be finite distance, it can be infinite distance. Okay, this is the long answer question. So can we, I want to take feedback from you now, or not feedback, at least can I complete this long answer? It doesn't, I think, two slides or three slides. Yeah, four slides, approximately four slides there. Can I complete this long answer 20 marks question for now, otherwise 12 marks. Can I complete this 20 marks question, or do you think it's overloaded, sir? We don't want to. It's up to you. I'm giving you full freedom, 3D degree of freedom. I am with you guys. So I whatever you would like to, I'll just feedback from 5 to 6 people. Can I complete it or no? Or can go for tomorrow? Tell me. Yes, sir, you can proceed with 20 marks. Amulya, then others, please. Amulya, I don't want, I mean, I want other members too. I know you are okay, but Shiva Yadav, yes, sir. Then others. Prashant, yes, sure, sir. Very much. Okay, then still. Prashant over, then remaining others? No? Others are not interested? Only three members, four members? Nitish, yes sir. Prashant, yes sir. Okay, continue, continue. Okay, very good. As you wish, Naveen. So, okay, Naveen, you are, continue, Pooja. Very good. So, let us make it successfully complete this question. Or else, if you want break tomorrow, I'll get the again poll from you. If you want break, otherwise, we'll continue to, 1 week and finish this chapter, then take break. Whatever, I'll take a poll from you. Continuous classes or alternate day classes. It's up to you. But you can keep your postings in the group. Continuous classes or alternate classes. Please post in the what chat box. Meanwhile, I'll start this. So, Fraunhofer diffraction. So, Fraunhofer diffraction. So, continuous. We'll at least tomorrow will be their class anyway, because I want to monitor this regularity. So you can give you a poll, but I try to, anyway, Fraunhofer diffraction, circular aperture. And what is the meaning here? Circular meaning is, why? So why we are keeping a circle? This is a circular aperture here. So it could be single slit, it could be double slit, it could be circular aperture, whatever. You can keep like this, like whatever. So you can keep the circular. So now the question is, we are keeping the circular aperture. Okay, sir, that's good. So here, Fraunhofer means we are considering the Fraunhofer diffraction, which means the waves are coming from infinity distance. There is no limit here. They are coming from infinity distance, and image also very long distance. Okay. And they're coming from here and falling on here. This is a, slit, and that can be, slit is here. You can keep circular slit. And this is the lens we are keeping to collect the images actually. So actually this is a slit, circular slit. And this is the lens which collect the image and put it on the screen. Okay. Yes, correct. Here, circular aperture. Very good. So, AB is the slit. AB is the slit. Very good. This is the slit. First point, I got it, sir. AB is the slit. CP is its axis. Okay. It's good. Right? AB is the slit. And CD is the, this is the, what is actually CP is the axis. So, CP is the axis. Okay, but it's not correct, but yeah. And if we rotate about the CP axis, we get AB is a circular aperture with a source of infinity. At the first point is clear. Second point, if we rotate this axis, idi manaku chudadaniki, how it looks, slit ila undi. But when you rotate it, it's a circle actually. It is a circle. Okay. So, if you rotate about the CP axis, we get AB as a circular aperture with a source at infinity. With a source at infinity. This is a screen. A plane wave front is incident on the circular aperture. Third point is, plane wave is incident on the circular aperture. Very nice. The secondary wave traveling in the direction of CO. CO is this direction, same principle, axis. With a central maximum. Ikkada manaku em ostundi central maximum. We are going to get central maximum. All the second waves coming from the all points equidistant from O. So from O. Equidistant from O, travel the same distance before reaching the P. Ikka nunchi manaku, so they are equidistant from the O. Okay, so now all these 4.5 points are over. Let me summarize this description about First point is AB is a slit, CP is the axis. When we rotate the CP axis, we can get the circular aperture of AB. Then the plane wave is actually incident on the circular aperture over. The secondary wave is traveling in the direction of CO, which produce the maximum, central maximum. All secondary waves are coming from the equidistance from O. They are travel the same distance before reaching the P. And the source should be placed infinity. So is it clear all points here? 5 points are clear? Yes, sir. Okay. Wow, great. Akhila, okay, Amulya, Gautami, Sahib. Very nice. So great response from the all my dear great scientists. Nice. So now the question, 25 members joined today out of 34 commitment. 25, you can, take this in a screenshot with 25, we'll keep it and track it. I mean, I will have attendance from the Google form, but I want proof. I have to send this to principal and university every day. So whenever I'll take the class, I want to be track all these things. So I need a proof from the screenshot too. Okay. And they will reinforce one another. What is the meaning of reinforce? Anybody know reinforce meaning? Can anyone put it in the in a chart? Reinforce. Reinforce ante reinforce meaning the together, right? Kalsipod, the together reinforce one another and form the and produce the diffraction to make not so strong, I would say, to have the diffraction to form a diffraction, strong in the general case, but here it's a different case. The waves reinforce to get the diffraction. Very good. Let us consider another case that secondary waves traveling in the direction inclined at an angle theta in a direction of CP. Previously, no theta. We did not consider the theta. We said they are equidistant, right? Now there is a theta. We are considering there is a theta. They are not coming. You can see this is the secondary waves are traveling in the direct inclined angle, not parallelly. So before it was like this. Now they are coming like this. So they are inclined. And what is the meaning of incline? It's like a slope. There should be a slope. All these secondary waves meet at a P1 on the screen. P1 on the screen. So when you change the angle, when you allow the rays to fall inclinedly, you have the pattern, diffraction pattern should be at P1. How much displacement, tell me? Starting ఇప్పటికి ఎంత డిఫరెన్స్ వచ్చింది x. How much it is? X displacement. So now PP1 is equal to x. The path difference of which? Path difference which are coming from the AB is AD. What is AD beta? This is the path difference. So angle change అయింది కాబట్టి the path difference how much it is now, because we change this like this inclined ga change chesam inta munduku ila undi, so we change that into slit like this. So when you change this, what happened, Anna? Because this wave and this wave, this started front before than this wave, so there is a path difference how much beta? AD. How much it is? AD. So AD can be calculated. How do we calculate AD, Nana? How do we calculate it? Can anyone tell that? AD, how can we get that? How can we गेट दैट एडी,
अपोजिट साइड बैड डिफेंस
करेक्ट. सो विच इज एक्चुअली लेट्स से, सो दिस कॉस थीटा साइन थीटा इज इक्वल टू, साइन थीटा इज इक्वल टू एडी बाय स्मॉल डी. स्मॉल डी इज हाउ मच इट इज हियर, ए बी, राइट? ओ, सो ए बी इज अ स्मॉल डी. लेट मी व्हाट इज दिस? सो ए डी इज हाउ मच? दिस वन बेस, राइट? हाउ मच इट इज टेल मी? साइन थीटा इज इक्वल टू अपोजिट, राइट? वेरी गुड, यू आर राइट अमूल्या. सो अपोजिट इज हाउ मच? हियर इज थीटा, सो अपोजिट इज ए डी. ए डी बाय हियर हाइपोटेन्यूज इज एक्चुअली दिस, राइट? हाइपोटेन्यूज हाउ मच इट इज हियर? इफ दिस इज अ बेस, इफ दिस इज अ बेस एंड दिस इज हाइपोटेन्यूज बेटा, इफ यू कंसिडर दिस इज अ बेस, हाइपोटेन्यूज शुड बी इक्वल टू ए बी, ए बी, सॉरी ए डी, ए डी बाय ए बी. इज इट ओके? इज इट व्हाट आई एम डूइंग इज करेक्ट और समथिंग रॉन्ग? आई हैव टू मेक ए ट्राइंगल परफेक्टली. सो फ्रॉम हियर आई हैव टू पाइथागोरस थ्योरम, साइन थीटा इज इक्वल टू अकॉर्डिंग टू द रिजल्ट ए डी बाय ए बी. डज इट मेक सेंस प्लीज? पाइथागोरस थ्योरम, इज इट ओके? हियर ए बी इज हाउ मच? ए बी इज एक्चुअली स्मॉल डी बेटा. ए बी इज इक्वल टू इट्स द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन द स्लिट विड्थ. सो नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू गेट ए डी फ्रॉम हियर. ए डी इज इक्वल टू, दैट्स करेक्ट ओनली, राइट? ए डी इज एक्चुअली वॉट? अपोजिट साइड बाय हाइपोटेन्यूज. यू हैव टू कंसिडर दिस इज योर बेस बेटा एंड दिस इज अपोजिट, दिस इज अ एक्चुअली हाइपोटेन्यूज. सो ए डी इज इक्वल टू डी साइन थीटा. इज इट क्लियर? प्लीज पुट इट इन द चार्ट बॉक्स. ट्रायंगल ए बी डी, दिस इज द ट्रायंगल ए बी डी वी टुक इट. यस अकिला, गुड गुड. अमूल्या, गुड, वेरी नाइस. ओ वी आर मूविंग वेरी क्लियरली नाउ. फ्रॉम दिस स्लाइड आई थिंक वी गोट अ लिटिल बिट ऑफ प्रीवियस स्लाइड. वी जस्ट यू नो लर्न व्हाट वाज द हियर. वी जस्ट डिस्क्राइब्ड इट विथ ए नॉर्मल, विथ ए नॉर्मल विदाउट एनी इंक्लाइन, राइट? सो वी गॉट ए इमेज एट पी, देन वी चेंज द यू नो वी चेंज द एंगल इंक्लाइन, वी गॉट द एट पी वन द डिफरेंस, पाथ डिफरेंस पी पी वन इज इक्वल एक्स, पाथ डिफरेंस शुड बी विच इज ए डी, ए डी इज इक्वल साइन थीटा, वी गॉट इट. ओके, फॉर अ डार्क फ्रिंज, फॉर ए डार्क फ्रिंज द कंडीशन इज एक्चुअली, डार्क फ्रिंज बेटा द कंडीशन इज हाउ मच नाना? डी साइन थीटा इज इक्वल टू एन लैम्डा. फॉर मैक्सिमम इंटेंसिटी और ब्राइट फ्रिंज डी साइन थीटा इक्वल टू एन प्लस वन लैम्डा. दीज आर द कंडीशंस बेटा, यू शुड रिमेंबर दैट. ओके, सर्कुलर अपर्चर डार्क फ्रिंज इज d sin theta is equal to n lambda. Like Newton's ring also we did reverse, right? It reversed. So maximum intensity d sin to n plus 1 lambda. These two conditions should be able to remember it. So Fraunhofer diffraction pattern due to circular aperture is a great importance in the study of resolving power of the telescope and microscope. సో ఎందుకు సార్ మనకు ఫ్రాన్హోఫర్ ఎందుకు ఇంపార్టెన్స్ అనేది జస్ట్ పాయింట్ పెట్టాను ఇక్కడ. ఇట్స్ గుడ్ టు కీప్ ఆర్ ఎల్స్ ఇట్స్ ఓకే, యూ డోంట్ నీడ్. ఎస్ ఎన్ ఈజ్ గుడ్, 1, 2, 3, రైట్ సైడ్ రషిం ఫాతిమా, ఇట్స్ గుడ్, యు ఆర్ రైట్. సో ఫ్రాన్హోఫర్ డైఫ్రాక్షన్ ప్యాటర్న్ ఎందుకు మనకు, వాట్ ఈస్ ద ఇంపార్టెన్స్ ఆఫ్ దీస్ డైఫ్రాక్షన్ సార్, వై వీ నీడ్ టు స్టడీ సార్? ఇట్ జస్ట్ ఇట్స్ ఇంపార్టెన్స్ ఈస్ టు స్టడీ ద రిజాల్వింగ్ పవర్ ఆఫ్ ది టెలిస్కోప్ అండ్ మైక్రోస్కోప్. You know the telescope, right? To see the object from far distance. You know the microscope, right? To see the object from the near distance. Wow! Telescope to see the stars, microscope to see the like a virus. Telescope can be useful to see the stars, sun. Microscope can be used to see the virus, bacteria, nanoparticle, etc. So this is extra point that you have to remember. Someone asks you what is the importance. If why we use Fraunhofer, why not Fresnel sir? Ante Fraunhofer la source infinity daggara untundi kabatti. We keep the source at infinity kabatti. Sun rays kani stars kani anni kuda infinite distance lo untayi kabatti. Whereas Fresnel lo daggara untayi kabatti you cannot. Okay. Right. If P1 is the point of minimum intensity, then all point at the same distance from P as P1 lying on the circle of radius x will be the minimum intensity. Circle erpadtadu betta itla P ki P1 ki you have the x distance tone you have the circle. The diffraction pattern due to a circular aperture consists of central bright curl airy rings. Very very important point. What is the airy rings an adutaru competitive exam? What is the airy ring? What is the airy ring? So airy ring is a which comes due to the circular aperture in a Fraunhofer diffraction. And airy ring is the central bright which comes due to the circular aperture in a Fraunhofer diffraction. Is it clear? And this last point is very very important for competitive exams. Any doubts from this slide? You should remember all these points. Any doubts, please post it in the group chat box. No doubt, Naveen. No sir, no sir, Amulya. Very nice. Good, good. Very active participation. Today you got more energy, I guess. Challenging. Circular aperture, last line. For a dark fringe, if the collecting lens is there, collecting lens. Adutarle, what is the importance of lens ante which collect the image and fall on the screen? What is importance of lens in a circular aperture case ante which basically collect the image? Very good. And near the slit, when the screen is at an large, whatever. Yeah, this. So basically we have to keep it in the near distance. For dark already we completed, for maximum intensity we already completed. Okay, sin theta is actually when the theta is small we can write theta. Theta is equal to x by f. So how come itself, we're gonna discuss that. Also find the first secondary minimum. So d sin theta is equal to first secondary ante n is equal to 1. First secondary n is equal to 1, d sin theta is equal to lambda. Okay, sin theta is equal. Don't. Someone is trying to unmute and disturb me. I don't want to. Hello. Who is that? Right. So I blocked you. So you cannot do anymore. That's it. Also. So first secondary, so n is equal to 1, that's good. From here, theta is how much, tell me? Sin theta is equal to theta, because theta is very small there. And I can write it as a d by lambda, right? D by lambda. So d by lambda or lambda by d? No, it's a d by lambda, right? D by lambda. No, lambda by d. Sorry. You should able to, right? Very nice. So is it? What is that? It's a lambda by d, right? Lambda by d. Very nice. So theta we got it as a lambda by d, and we also got x by f from the figure. From the diagram, we get this. So you make it equate these two, Nana. So when you equate it, when you equate it, because they both are sin theta, so what you going to get it? Tell me. A x, you have to calculate the x is equal to fl lambda by t. Here x is the radius of any disk, and you're going to get x is equal to 1.22. So focal length here we take as approximately 1.22, and this is the final equation. Every disk radius find out chase equation it is. So maybe you have doubt, how can you get this one? Is it clear? Do you have a doubt? Yes or no? X by F ela vachindi? X by
sin theta equal to x by
F. Ah, ela vachindi anna mari? ఇది ఎక్స్ నాన్న ఎక్స్ ఇది ఎక్స్ బై ఎఫ్ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు టీటా రావాల. సో దిస్ మస్ట్ బి ఈక్వల్ టు దిస్ మస్ట్ బి ఈక్వల్స్ టు వాట్ ఎవర్ ద ఫోకల్ లెంత్. ఐ థింక్ ఫోకల్ లెంత్ షుడ్ బి ఇట్స్ ఎ డిస్టెన్స్ ఫ్రమ్ ది లెంత్ ఫ్రమ్ హియర్ వేర్ దే మీట్ రైట్ హియర్ ఐ గెస్ from here to here. So x by f ante idi manaku em avutundi? Oh, triangle, you have to make triangle again here. So I have to make, I think, let us say this is the, I don't know, I think okay, sin theta.
So radius is the x kada sir?
Yeah, I know that this is x, x by f, right? Correct. Sin theta is equal to,
x is the focal length of lens.
Very good, very good. Yeah, x is the f, x by f, right?
And up. AC equal to AB sin theta.
Correct. Very good. Yeah, I got it. So this by this we gonna get it. I am done. Okay, so we got this. How do we get x by f anedi? We just learn it, you just equate it, and over. Question is over. That's over. Long answer is over. Any doubts? Sorry for taking little bit more time, but as I promised before, 45 minutes. I think few members also left, which is I want to see that, but maybe I can consider today. I don't want to give the punishment, but once you join, you should supposed to stay till end of the class. That is my condition next. Or you have to inform, sir, I have an issue. Otherwise, something disconnected, immediately join and tell that. But don't tell lies. Okay? So that's what I am going to do very serious from now. Okay? You have to understand. See, the faculty members may even take a part to know. It's not easy. Nana. You have to keep everything on the slide and say, that's technology, you have to use it. Lot of time to make one class, definitely 3-4 hours you have to work hard. You should understand and attend the classes. Feeling so bad actually. That is the reason I took a decision. Just 20 members enough for my class. 25 is enough my class. I don't need 80 members. Out of 25, 5 members scientists line up, 5 members if they get a job somewhere, feeling so happy. Okay? Any doubts, Nana, can you keep in the, can you post in the chat? Any question, please? Can I close it?